Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, we want to learn how to use HIV 1 and 2 test strip to test for HIV 1 and 2. So I'm hoping to be a short video and a very comprehensive one. Okay, so to test for HIV 1 and 2 in the lab, we have this test strip. This one was developed by Abbott. We are going to use it and know how it's used. Then we have this one also. What's special about this one is that it is able to differentiate between HIV-1 and HIV-2. This one will just develop one test line, so it wouldn't really differentiate between the two. So we have this one developed by Abbott, and then we have this one which is able to develop the 1 and 2. So as you can see here, we have the 1 here, the test line for 1, the test line for 2, and then the control. And then we also have the OraQuick. We'll also learn how to use the OraQuick in this video. So quickly, let me put the OraQuick aside. We'll learn how to use this one, which is developed by Abbott. Okay, so you take the test strip and then you peel it open. Good. So after peeling it open, you are going to take your blood sample. I have the blood sample here. This is whole blood. So you have your whole blood here. What you do is that you are going to spin it to obtain the serum. Because this test is antigen antibody test. And I'm going to explain more of that into details. So I have a sample here. It has been spun already. So I'll just take and put the serum at the sample area. So let me demonstrate that quickly. So this is it, and so with my Pasteur pipette, I have aspirated some of the sample. So I'm going to put it in my sample area. To 2 or 3 drops is enough. I put the rest back, and then I discard my Pasteur pipette. So I close it. So you're actually going to wait for 10 to 15 minutes. So this is basically our timer. So that's how you use this one. So while this one is running, we'll do this one. This one, you can apply the whole blood, and then there is a buffer here that you also put inside. So let me apply the whole blood here. So just a drop is enough here, and then you apply your buffer. 2 drops is enough, and you also wait for the same amount of time. So while they move up, let me try and explain the principle behind this test. Okay, so this is a typical drawing of the HIV virus. So it has the RNA genome. So it has 2 positive sense RNA genome, and then it's surrounded by a nucleocapsid. Then it also has a plasma membrane which it derives from the host cell. So one important thing about the virus is that it has these glycoproteins, that's GP41, GP120, and this is the antigen that we actually use in the development of the test kit. So it's very important. Apart from GP41 and GP120, there's another important antigen that is here. That's the P24 antigen. That's a nucleocapsid antigen. It's here. So it's the same thing here. This is GP41. Okay, so this is a picture of the HIV virus. Okay, so how does this thing work? So let me use this picture to demonstrate for you. So this is a typical drawing of the test cassette. So there's a nitrocellulose membrane in there. This is where you put the sample, and then within the nitrocellulose membrane is a conjugate of the antigen, that's in this case the GP41 and then GP36, and then this antigen has been conjugated to colloidal gold and it's been infused into the nitrocellulose membrane. Good. So what happens is that you are going to introduce the antibodies into the sample area as we did here. So when you introduce, the antibody is going to bind with the conjugate colloidal gold antigen complex. So when that happens, when they bind together, they are going to move up the nitrocellulose membrane, and then at the test region 1 is where GP41 antigen is, and then the test region 2 is where GP36 antigen is. So as the recombinant HIV 1 and 2 antigen conjugate with colloidal gold moves up, it's then also later detected by the antigen at test line position 1. That is if the person is reactive for that. Okay, good. So these are the antigens that are in the test kit. This test kit has both the GP41 and then GP36, so it's able to differentiate between HIV1 and HIV2. And then this one, it uses the capsid protein, that is P24, as I showed you in this diagram. So it's actually using this antigen P24, so it was developed for this particular antigen. Okay, so that's about that. So we are still waiting for our sample to finish. Okay, so we've done about 5 minutes. So while we wait, let's look at the Oraquick. It's also very, very simple. You can use a mouth specimen or you can use blood. So to use a mouth specimen, very simple, you open the Oraquick, you take out the stick, and then you put, it says that swab completely along the outside of the upper gum. So you do that, and then you also do the same for the lower gum. It has a buffer in there. You put the swab stick into the buffer and wait for 20 to 40 minutes. You can do the same with blood, capillary blood, or even whole blood. So you you can get an applicator and pick some of the capillary blood, and then put it into the buffer, stir it for a while, and then you put the stick into the preparation. Wait for 20 to 40 minutes. So I'll quickly open it and then we'll see how it looks like. So here we go. This is how the stick looks like, and then this is how the buffer looks like. So you open it like this, and then with the help of a Pasteur pipette, you can transfer about 10 microliters of blood into the buffer we have here. So here's my pipette. I'll just transfer an amount of it. Into here to make, and then you stir. So it looks like this. Then you simply put the the steak in there. That is if you are using blood. So you also wait for about 20 minutes for this one. Okay, so basically that is how HIV is tested for in the lab. I hope you got something from it. So it's basically we are detected antibodies produced against the capsid protein or the glycoprotein produced by the HIV virus, and they, when they are detected, they mark as a line. So in this one is showing negative for both HIV 1 and 2, and then also here, this is the control line. If it's positive, we'll have the test line show here, so it's also negative. So the Oracle will also run and later also show. So basically that is it for this video. Thank you, and I hope you learned something from here.